Hello, welcome everyone. Thank you for joining me. I am tagging. So I'll be joining an organization that's out in India. I want to post their IG or her IG. Priya will be coming on. She is India's first cannabis activist. And she's also a TEDx speaker, a cancer survivor, and she is responsible for a lot of the cannabis legislation that has happened in India. Right now, their government is accepting opinions from people all across the world to help them get what they need done. So I'm excited that she'll be joining us. Thank you so much for tuning in. And without further ado, I will be bringing in Priya to join us on this awesome conversation, because she's going to be able to educate us. And you guys know I love doing the educational stuff. Hello.
Hi, namaste.
Namaste, welcome. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me over. I just want to make a quick correction out here. I'm a survivor of lymph node tuberculosis.
Okay.
Though I do counsel cancer patients, having said that, God has been a little kind over here that I did end up getting tuberculosis and not, you know, cancer, because I cannot even imagine the pain that, you know, the patients go through. I can only understand a little and assist them with medicines out there. Yeah.
All
so
right.
Again, thank you so much for having me over and for giving me all the support, Tammy. I mean, you've been nothing but, you know, a soul sister out there in international waters for us and guiding as much as you can in spite of the fact that we have still not met yet.
Yeah. Well, I'm so glad that we have crossed. And it's a thank you really to the citizens of India who pushed and pushed to make sure that I got in contact with you. And I'm so grateful to be able to have this conversation with you and to share with others. Can you quickly break down the state of India and what your guys' legalization looks like?
All right, so, you know, as we talk today, in November 2020, apart from having 6 states in India legal for cultivation, processing, manufacturing, and sales of cannabis products, India also has a new narcotics amendment bill out there for the locals or the citizens rather to vote for. Having said that, the center government has always been a little more kind toward this plant, especially when they did issue a circular a few years back asking the state governments. So it's just the opposite how you guys have it in US, where state governments allow cannabis, wherein federally it's illegal. Mm-hmm. State governments are taking their own sweet time to allow the plant, wherein the center government has said, we understand, we have external ministries, we have international, links, and we understand it's a medicinal plant and an industrial plant. So if you have the capacity, the capability to take such a topic up in your state, you can. No one is going to stop you from that. Now, having said that, this does give a lot of people the open hand to never allow this plant to come on top. So yeah,
right.
That's where we're struggling just a little.
Can you talk about your efforts and how you helped legalize cannabis in some of these states?
Well, sure. You know, it has been an amazing roller coaster ride or a journey, like all of us, Tammy. I'm pretty sure you also have a very colorful story out here regarding cannabis, because that is what cannabis is. You know, cannabis helps the person to reach their maximum potential as well. So I would like to say that in the last 5 years, I connected with some amazing, people, authorities, citizens, doctors, who all assisted me in their own states to work it forward. For example, the first state which legalized in India was Uttarakhand. That's where Shiva, as we all know, Shiv Shankar, Shivji, the one who is behind me right now, he's closely associated with the plant, and Uttarakhand is the state where his home is, per se. You know, all his major temples together are in that particular state. So that state went ahead and announced that, considering the government also sells cannabis leaf in India under religious sacrament, This is very funny because you will find government shops, all right, where they usually have, in your case, social security number update or things like that. In my case, the Aadhaar card number update. Such kind of government-run shops also sell cannabis leaf because it's related to this one who's standing just behind me,
Wow.
this is the beauty of India. So in 2015, when Uttarakhand said, 2016, when Uttarakhand said we will allow, there were over 50 companies who ran towards this state. Now, post the company starting their business, only half of them did get licenses because everyone thinks that only with a sheet of paper they can just go and get a license. So it's a little different in US and in India. There are a lot of activists out there, but those activists, at this particular time are missing out on collaborating or working in conjunction with the government. Only reason is you can actually make a long-lasting change is via talking and not via fighting all the time. And that is what helped Hempathy or me in this entire journey. We had open dialogues. I barged into most of the minister's office saying that I'm a patient. These are my reports. These are the samples that I have. Would you want to understand how your state can earn millions in revenue overnight? That was all that I said. And everyone had the similar expression, their eyes just opened up. Because at the end of the day, the government wants to understand what is in it for them. Medicine is a part of it. Industrial products, biotech products, or sustainable products are a part of it. But what is the immediate gain also of those people? Immediate gain is unlimited amount of revenue which would be generated. Right now, it is under black. So you're not even getting $1 out of it. Now you will get millions each month, And post Uttarakhand, I also went to Uttar Pradesh. That's where my father and my mother were born. So I went to that particular state. Again, I had a very positive response. I got connected to Madhya Pradesh. The company I was consulting at that time, they got a license to actually open a cannabis-oriented hospital over 60 acres in India, Madhya Pradesh. But they have still not kicked off. It's been like a year and a half. And they got the permissions, the licenses are out, yet they have not kicked off the project. So that is where we also lack. People get their licenses and then they disappear. I don't know for what. They are getting investments, they want to gain more investments and then come back. But this also makes the government think twice. Are we doing the right thing? Yes or no? Because ideally they should have at least been through 20% of the construction work for the hospital, and as we talk, 1.5 years later as well, they have still not started the work. Now, apart from Madhya Pradesh, there is a state called Odisha, which is a tribal state. The reason I'm mentioning tribal over here is because India has different Tribal and Forest Dweller Act or law. Now, this is the beauty yet again. They are allowed to use anything available around them as a commodity. That is the law because they have very limited things. They have very limited resources. So what do you know? What would these people do? They can utilize cannabis. They can utilize cotton. They can utilize wheat. It doesn't matter because for them, these things were way before. Since the time Constitution was made, they and their culture has been there since thousands of years. They cannot change and they would not change. And hence, Odisha went ahead and without legalizing, said it's a part of our act. I mean, it's a part of our state. We will go ahead and we will do this. And that was one thing. I will show you a. So this is what the tribals are making in Odisha. This is what the tribals. So this is the raw material is collected by this company, from the tribals, and then they go ahead and make these medicines. Now, these are the kind of medicines that are being used for cancer pain, from headache to cancer pain. Now, what is legal in India at this particular time? 90% of the companies have a unlimited CBD and 0.3% THC license. Now, Tammy, you realize that itself is gold, right? Yeah, because most of the countries are not even allowing 30 to 40% of CBD. Forget about 30 to 40% CBD. They are not even allowing 20-25% CBD, right? India is allowing unlimited amount of CBD till the time you can prove it is needed. Okay, so if you tomorrow come to India and say, I need a ratio of, let's say, 5 is to 30. So THC is to CBD, 5 is to 30 you need. The government will ask you to submit clinical trials, researches, and your product breakdown of what you are asking. And if you can prove it, you will get the license.
Wow, that's a lot of loopholes to have to jump through.
See,
So
it's not a loophole exactly. What we did is, in the legalization bit, we involved the doctors and the scientists, cannabisologists throughout. I was more or less like a catalyst or a bridge because those country people were not that government trusting. So they were trusting an activist. And I shared their researches with the government and they were shocked. So they said, we cannot limit science. That's for sure. But we just cannot give licenses to everyone. That is so
true.
fair, right? That is pretty much fair.
True. So I have been talking today in my stories about what we can do to help push your legalization efforts forward, because in America we're getting big gains and it looks like that we might have cannabis legalization soon. But as an American, I am cognizant that cannabis legalization in other parts of the world is also beneficial to us, because what you're doing is you're creating a broader market, which is ultimately good for the planet. What can we do here and in other parts of the world where we're watching to help advance the movement that's happening in India?
Come to India as soon as possible. That is one thing that you all can do because we do have a lot of portion which is legal already. As I said, from government selling the cannabis leaves up to such kind of medicines which are being made A by tribals and by pharma companies as well. What we lack right now is the kind of business available for these people or these companies because they have got the license. India has a lot of agriculture land. We have always been an agriculture-based country or an economy, right? Now, today, if we have the land available, we do lack a little bit of expert subject matter understanding. Having said that, the tribals still have good understanding of the plant because they saved it through. The forest dwellers or the mountain people, they still have a good amount of knowledge on the subject. So if we can put these two together and help them evolve, for example, get certain scientists, cannabisologists to work on Indian strains. India has 1500 plus indigenous strains right now, Tammy. That is cataloged. Imagine.
Yeah, we have to get to India, can of fam.
Come
Wow.
soon over here.
That
Yeah.
is
So that
insane,
is one
1500.
thing. And we have just cataloged it, So we don't know what exactly is in those catalog strains. We know where they come from, but we don't know how much THC is in it, how much CBD is in it, or CBG, CBN, or do we have extra compounds which are not available anywhere in the world? Because this entire industry is so new, right? Each year we are adding more compounds. So what if we have certain things available out here? So we really need that expert collaboration. And if possible, we as a country have always been fair in putting a price at the product. India has been a massive supplier of raw products, spices, agriculture products, and more. So if we can have business ties, legal business ties on this front, it will help those tribals and farmers who have kept the plant alive in India, which, as we all say, is the land of Shiva. And he's the god of cannabis. So yeah.
Yes, absolutely. So, with talking about that, can you tell us about the Indian hemp market? Because we always hear about Indian hemp.
All right. So Indian hemp, the first time I actually heard or understood about Indian hemp was Indian Hemp Commission report of 1895. Now, Indian hemp is something that has been there in the culture for the longest time. I'll show you guys a few things. Okay, just one second. So, what you see out here is this is the raw fiber. Okay, now this raw fiber itself is pretty strong. All right, and that this what you see is the very tribal way to make hemp fiber out of it. And after that is when we make such kind of products. This entire thing, our farmers are very, very advanced, I would say. They have made these products without any help, wherein these things are made, again, hemp products, which are made with machines. This is what they have made with hand machine, hand woven. All right.
That
So
is so
if you
cool.
look at the Indian hemp, this is exactly where it started from. Because if you come to Himalayas today, you will find people, and especially the priests or the shamans, wearing slippers made out of hemp.
Oh, wow.
For them, yes. For them, the only thing that they can actually wear on their feet, per se, is this. And I'll tell you why. Because the Indian hemp, again, came out, as we say, from Amrit Manthan. Amrit Manthan is churning of the ocean. And we have a scripture. India has a lot of scriptures. All right. Now, one is called Shiv Puran, which is the story of Shiva, his existence, and his victories, achievements, losses, failures, everything. Now, that does mention about churning of the ocean. And it talks about cannabis coming out from the last drop of the nectar. That is why this entire Himalayan belt, from Kashmir, Afghanistan, up till Arunachal for us, and furthermore, has wild cannabis growing. No one puts the seeds out there. On the highways, when you will come, you will find so much cannabis growing on both the sides. Please go to my Insta handle and check out some of the videos. You will be surprised,
Wow.
shocked, and probably in trance by just looking at it, that it's growing on national highways. And so much that only by collecting that, you can become a millionaire. You can make hemp fiber products, you can make papers, you can make so much cloth, there is hempcrete, and so on and so forth. Our ancestors did the same thing, but they never, wrote it down in this manner. So as I told you, the shamans wear the slippers, right? They say that because we get earthing from the earth, this helps with the insulation, or this helps in cutting down the additional energy which can be harmful. Then we have certain monuments which are thousands of years old, and they have traces of cannabis in the building of them. So we have Ajanta Alora Caves, we have something in Alibag, which is called in Maharashtra, which is called a Black Kailash. Kailash is actually in the Himalayas, but this temple was carved out of one single mountain. It's in Maharashtra. I am going to take you all, I promise, over, to all these beautiful places, right? So now this particular temple has a layer of cannabis oil on it so that the stones don't crumble down. Imagine how advanced our ancestors were in this front,
Yes, I could only
Now,
imagine what
secondly,
they know it can do. Yeah.
they were so advanced. I mean, I'm not surprised that the Egyptians, especially the pharaohs, they had a certain amount of cannabis in their tombs. Because here as well, in certain rituals that we have in India, in Sanatan or Hinduism, we use cannabis first thing, A, for prasad or offering, as we call it, B, as a manner of celebration. So in both of them, in praying and in celebration, we are using this plant which is embedded in the culture. So the first time when I saw cannabis probably was when I was 3 years old. My mom, it was Shivratri, and my mom plucked a few leaves out of it and she had put it on the Shivling, because the Rudra Abhishek, or the prayer to this deity, this God's God, as we call him, Shiva, is incomplete without a cannabis leaf on top of it. So since then, this entire plant is embedded. Post that, with time, because my grandfather is a half Nepalese, rather he was a Nepalese, so I'm like half Nepalese there. So he used to tell me stories about Pashupatinath and about how there are certain medicinal herbs, even at that time he used to say. But I never had an understanding. I always thought these are the stories that your grandparents try to tell you, that nature has a cure for everything, as he used to say, right? So I always thought that. until I got tuberculosis. And when I got tuberculosis, I met few Ayurvedic doctors and few international people, rather connected with them. And then they told me the strength of the Indian hemp and how it can cure a lot of things. And patients are getting the oil in US, Germany, everywhere illegally on the basis that they still need the best, right? These are the parents of those hybrids which have traveled across. So the parents would still have a higher or a stronger DNA gene, right? Which could probably cure an ailment or a disease in half the time than a hybrid, because it's all organic, right? So I'm glad that within 3.5 months, I was completely cured of tuberculosis, and I was told that I need to go through a surgery. And look at me, I'm talking nonstop. What surgery? I had here, the tuberculosis was here. So this was swollen till here,
Oh,
like till
wow.
here. And this went back. When someone meets me, they still see a little bulge because the skin expanded, right? It went till here. But it went back because the entire pus was flushed out of my system. It came out of my system, it dried out.
And you did all that with cannabis.
Yes, the cannabis oil as well as the smoking method. In Ayurveda, that is the science of life, we talk about smoking in a very high position. It is called dhoomapan, which simply means that you can intake smoke to heal yourself. The same way anesthesia is used, the very same way other herbs or plants can be used for a smoking method. You and I would like rice in very different forms. You may like it in pudding. I may like it with my gravy. That doesn't mean, your method is right and mine is wrong, right?
Correct.
It's a
Correct.
personal and an individual choice.
Correct.
Till
I agree.
the time the rice itself is available, not harming anyone, and it's used for medicinal or, let's say, methods or purposes which are beneficial. Even recreational, for that matter of fact, I got safe because some people were still utilizing the recreational. But I want to highlight here, most of the recreational users don't realize they they do it for medicinal reasons.
Yes, exactly. Whether they acknowledge it or not, you are medicating. You have an
Yes.
endocannabinoid system. You are balancing your body. Yes.
Balancing body chakras, hormones, call it bringing happiness. Call it sleeping a little better. Call it giving you a little confidence. We have therapists for all of these things today, and we charge a bomb for each session. And this therapist is given by Shiva to all of us. So, I really feel that I'm blessed, first of all, Tammy, to be born and doing this activism in India. For a simple fact, people are more understanding that about the plant in a very childlike manner. When I say childlike manner, they have still not understood the exploitation of the plant. So if we can teach them the right method right away, they will never go towards the exploitation.
Correct.
And that's where you and your entire bandwagon, I would say, and international people also come in very helpful at this particular time, because there's only so much I can educate or prepare them for you guys. Because now I leveled them up to a point when they can learn from you guys. Then they will also level up. Hopefully, then they'll be able to make things which are groundbreaking. Because there's so much out here. As I said, on the highway itself, there is so much hemp that at least five international students from Amsterdam or any other university can come over here with a letter, collect it all, and then try some products. We will give all the kind of help available, just that we need experts on the subject.
Yeah, absolutely. So it sounds like in 2021, I'll be going to India because I want to see
You're
this.
welcome. I'm very happy to host you. And there will be, hopefully, when you do come down in 2021, we will have a lot more states, or rather, an entire national law would have been changed. Because we are right now in between of changing the same. So right now, India has, as I started with, has put a request out there, not only to its own citizens, but generally to the people, all right? All you have to do is you have to click on the form. It's available on my Insta handle. It's available on Tammy's Insta handle, Cannabis Cutie as well. Click
Yes.
on it, fill that form, and then send it across along with your suggestions regarding medicinal cannabis and other narcotics herbs. Do not limit yourself to cannabis only. We have a good chance to get cyclobin mushrooms and changa and a lot of herbs, ayahuasca, at one go legalized. So would you be up for it? Can you all do that? And trust me, international voice counts a lot.
Yes, International Voice counts a lot. And I do have the links. If you go to the link in my bio under Cannabis Reform, I have all of the links in a Google Drive with more information on what was discussed here now. But send journal articles, reports, papers, studies, documents, materials, your own perspective on healing. Anything that you can send over would be a great deal. The government of India needs as much input as possible. And like Priya mentioned, international voices do count heavily. So that's one way that we can take action to help push forward all of your efforts. And Hemp Bhati, Hemp, how do I say
Yes,
that?
thanks, Adi. Yes.
Yes, and those efforts as well. I'm so grateful to have hosted you tonight. I learned so much. You look beautiful. You are an incredible cannabis educator. I love your passion. I love everything that you're about. I hope that my audience learned today. It sounds like in the comments that they did. I really hope and pray that you guys can help take action. Go to the link in our bios. Please, please, please follow Priya and everything that she's doing. Bless you for all that you do. I'm going to be pushing all week. These opinions do have to be submitted by November 15th in America. In India, that would be November 16th is the deadline. So, yeah, this was
You
great.
guys have just a few days left. Please, please, please send in as many entries as possible. Tell your parents, tell your friends, anyone and everyone matters. The more number of people supporting this gets in, the more number of states, rather than national law, can be changed. We've done it in US, let's do it in India as well, and we all will celebrate the new year together. It will be
Yes.
one thing to watch, talking together
Yes.
on the 31st of December, all of us legally. There is the humans and this plant came in pretty much together. So there's
Yes.
no way that this plant is illegal and we are legal, right? So I'm
Exactly.
hoping that the government will understand that. And thank you, Tammy. It really means a lot, taking time out for us and going out of your way and talking to so many people, helping not just us out, but the entire country. Because right now, whatever we are doing it for the farmers, the patients, the doctors, the professionals, all of them together. I am the only, one who is out and about because there's so much stigma attached to it. They take their own sweet time to show their face over there, but they're assisting, they're helping. So they're all behind here. As soon as you take one step forward, they all will come out of hiding. So I'm
Yes.
hoping that, as soon as you guys are here, we will introduce you to the patients, the doctors, the authorities, who all have been very, very positive on the plant, and they'll be here to welcome all of you.
I love it. Yes, we're going to India, guys. Quickly, some of you are asking where the link is. If you go to the link in my bio, under Cannabis Reform, it's at the bottom button. There are three links. One is a Google Drive of information. One is the email address that you can directly send your opinion and suggestions to. And then the third one is a website for the form that would go directly to the government of India regarding the reform. So that's where you can find it on my end. Do you have anything else that you would like to add before we close?
Well, I think I am pretty happy right now. And what I will do is I will show you guys a little something of Indian hemp products. So you guys can just have a look and probably order these wherever possible. That CBD is not Indian, but yeah. Most of these products are all Indian hemp products that you see over here. Okay, so if at all you guys are interested, please go to their website. Please check out my page, and you will find. And this is just the beginning. This is pretty much just the beginning that we as a country today have. And I'm hoping that by. Ow. Okay.
Oh, are you there? Oh, you're back.
Yeah, I'm back. So I'm hoping by 2021, we all will be sitting together and in the factories of this very, these products. We have unlimited CBD, and if you can give a backup for unlimited THC medicinal products, Indian government is issuing the licenses. We have unlimited THC products licenses already out and about. So if you guys are interested, come down to India and I will assist you guys. Thank you so much. And I am technically challenged as you guys saw it right now.
You did so good. And again, thank you for joining everyone. Thank you for having us. We'll be pushing really hard this week to affect change, hopefully.
I'm hoping that we all can do this together. Thank you.
Oh, yeah, we can. You
Namaste.
have a beautiful morning and day. I am going to end my night.
Oh yes, we have a very, very beautiful morning out here. I'm in the Himalayas. I'm hoping to invite you guys pretty soon. This is how it is.
Wow.
So I'm hoping that you guys will be
Whoa.
here sooner.
Yes. Oh yeah, absolutely. It's happening 2021. The cannabis cutie is going to India.
Yes, India is waiting for you guys. Okay. Thank you
All
so much
right.
for
Have
this
a good
opportunity.
day.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Namaste.
All right, guys. Link in my bio. Cannabis reform. Says cannabis reform. There are three links there. One is to submit whatever papers, journals, articles that you can. International help is really going to help here. There's also a Google Doc with different companies, an assessment of the market, an education, a bio on Priya. And then you also have an email address where you can send your opinion to. I really think that this is a great way for us to affect change. With cannabis globally, here in America, we're getting things done. We are almost at the end and we are almost at federal legalization, but legalization in other parts of the world is also beneficial to us. There are other markets out there. So DM me if you have any other questions. I'll be making this push this week. If you support it, please make the push. Please share. Tell a friend, tell a family member. We can do this. This is what we're here for. I'm gonna have a good night with my kids, and I hope you guys have a good night or a good morning wherever you are too. Peace.